guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be bringing you another pregnancy update. This update will be for week 20 to 21 of my pregnancy. The day that you guys are seeing this, I am currently 22 weeks pregnant, which is crazy to think about. I can't believe that I'm already so far along, and I will be meeting my baby girl in 18 weeks or less, which is so exciting. According to my pregnancy app, she is about the size of an ear of corn, or my other app says she is the size of an eggplant. So she's getting pretty big, and she's weighing just over a pound right now. So if you guys missed my previous pregnancy update, or if this is the first video of mine you're watching, I will make sure to link my previous pregnancy update down below in the description box. It is from 17 weeks to 19 weeks, I believe. So I will have that one linked down below so that you guys can watch that after this one if you guys are interested in that. If you enjoy pregnancy updates or pregnancy related videos, make sure you hit the thumbs up button so that I know you guys are enjoying these. And if you're not already, I would love it if you would subscribe, follow along my pregnancy journey, and then get to meet baby girl once she arrives. If you guys have any pregnancy related video requests, leave them down below in the comments, because I'd love to produce more pregnancy related content, and I would love to put out content that you guys want to see. So if you have any recommendations, leave them down below for me. The first thing I'm gonna talk about is my rash. I talked about this in my previous pregnancy update. I had been getting a rash every now and then, and it was really, really bad, like covering my whole arms and legs, and it was so itchy and annoying. I had the rash again, so we did go to the ER, and they looked at it. They determined that it was some kind of allergic reaction. They didn't specify what I'm allergic to, but it was like a food allergy most likely. They kind of told me to look back at what I've ate around the same times that I've had the rash. So I did that, and I came up with these cosmic brownies. They are like little Debbie cake brownies. I'll insert a picture here if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, but they are so delicious. They're like my favorite treat ever. I've been having them for as long as I can remember, and I absolutely love them, but I had eaten them the same days that I always got the rash. So I didn't have those again, and I have not had them in a few weeks, and I have not had my rash either. So I'm pretty sure it's something in like the pre-packaged brownies that I was reacting to. And it only happens when I'm pregnant. So the doctor said with my hormone levels going up and things like that, you can become allergic to things that you're not normally allergic to. So I'm just gonna stay away from those and hope that the rash does not come back. So moving on to my cravings lately. They haven't really changed. I've still been craving a lot of chocolate, especially at nighttime after dinner. I just want like a Kit Kat bar or a Hershey bar. Chocolate chip cookies, anything chocolate after dinner, I just want to eat all of it. So that's like a big craving that I've been having, along with like a mocha frappuccinos, which I craved a lot with my first pregnancy, and I've been wanting those like nonstop this pregnancy as well. And my other big craving is still spicy foods. I want to eat everything spicy. I want like spicy chicken and spicy tacos, like everything. I just want super spicy. Funny story, I made chicken with taco seasoning the other day, and apparently I put a lot of the spicy taco seasoning on it because my husband was like, oh my goodness, this is so spicy. But to me, it was like perfect. It was so good. It was just the right spiciness for me, and it was delicious, which is kind of crazy because when I'm not pregnant, I don't like anything spicy. I won't even eat salsa because it's too spicy for me. So it's hilarious that all I want to eat is like spicy foods right now. And the only kind of food aversions that I'm having is I love my coffee, but for some reason, if I make homemade hot coffee in the morning, it just makes me so nauseated, which is hard because obviously I'm a mom of a toddler, and I need coffee in the morning, I need caffeine, I need something to wake me up and get me going. So I always have coffee, and I have not been able to have that lately because it just makes me so sick. So I've kind of switched to a caffeinated tea. I really like kombucha tea, or right now I'm drinking, it's like a tangerine flavored tea, but it has the caffeine in it. So I've been having that in the morning, and hopefully that will go away when this pregnancy ends, because when I have two kids under two, I'm gonna need all the coffee. My pregnancy symptoms have definitely been increasing. I've been having more symptoms, more things going on lately as I get farther along in my pregnancy. One thing that I've noticed that has really jumped up is my hunger. I am always hungry. I have to like force myself to stop eating because I just want to eat everything all the time. I'm so hungry all the time, and I just never want to stop eating. And that is so hard because obviously I don't want to gain a ton of extra weight this pregnancy, so I really have to like control myself and make myself not eat because I'm just so hungry all the time. It's crazy. Another symptom that has started is my pregnancy insomnia. I know the farther along you get in pregnancy, the harder it is to sleep, the less you sleep, you have to get up and go to the bathroom, and you just don't sleep as well. And that is definitely kicking in. There have been a few nights now where I've woken up and I have just been wide awake in the middle of the night and I cannot go back to sleep for what feels like hours. And then the next morning I'm just so tired because I did not get a good sleep. Thankfully, it is not all the time right now. It just happens every now and then. It is increasing though. My sleep is getting worse. I'm having to wake up more and go to the bathroom. And I wake up a lot more when I sleep because when I roll over or try to get comfortable again, it's just a lot harder with a big belly in the way. So it wakes me up, of course, and then it's harder to go back to sleep. Another symptom, which I've touched on in my previous pregnancy update, is my migraines. I'm still having them every now and then. They're not as constant as they used to be. They have definitely decreased a lot. And I do control them by taking medication my doctor has prescribed me, and caffeine will help. So if I have like a soda or if I go get a frappuccino and it has all that caffeine in it, that usually helps my migraines to go away. Something that I have really noticed lately that is really hard for me is I can tell that my patience level is getting smaller and smaller, and I think it's just because of my pregnancy, all my hormones, being tired, having my backache, just regular pregnancy things, and then having to chase around a toddler all the time. My patience level is definitely not what it is when I'm not pregnant, and it is so hard to try to think about that and to not just snap at my son or overreact to things that I know I'm only wanting to react that way because I'm pregnant and my hormones are just all over the place right now. But that's something that I have noticed, that I feel like my patience level is going down a little bit the farther along I get in pregnancy. And so I really have to be conscious of that and just try to make myself be patient, or just kind of just go in another room for a second and let my son do whatever he's doing, and then I can just like take a breath and then go back and talk to him and fix the situation more calmly. The most irritating symptom that has now started is I am having backaches all the time now. With my belly growing and I can feel my uterus stretching farther up my stomach, I can definitely feel it in my back now. I have a lot of like mid and lower back pain these days, and I know it's just gonna get worse as she gets bigger and my stomach stretches more. I'm just gonna get more backaches. So that's one of the symptoms that has just recently started in probably the past like week or so. So now that my belly's growing and she's growing, she is constantly moving all the time. I can feel her kick like nonstop all day long. And I've actually been able to put my hand on my stomach and feel her just like a little flutter on my hand. And I can also see her kick every now and then. And it's just like the tiniest little tap on my belly, but it is her kicking, so it's really exciting. And it was really special the other night. I was feeling her kick and I was watching my belly. And I told my husband, I was like, hey, she's kicking, you need to look at my belly. And he got to see her kick too. So that's so special for him to finally be able to see her kick. And I know soon he'll be able to feel it as well with his hands and feel like all of her movement and everything. Literally, it's the best thing about pregnancy. It's my favorite part. I love feeling her all the time. And I am so much more conscious about it this pregnancy than I was my first one. I'm just soaking it in more and just enjoying every little kick even more, because I know this is very possibly my last pregnancy. So I'm just soaking everything in this pregnancy and just trying to enjoy it as much as possible. About 2 weeks ago, I went in to get my 20-week anatomy scan. They looked over everything. They looked at her like kidneys, her liver, her heart, her brain, everything. And thankfully, everything looked good. She is looking perfect, they said. And she was absolutely adorable during the ultrasound. She would not stop moving. The ultrasound lasted about an hour and a half, and I swear the entire time she was constantly kicking and moving. She would flip up and down and she would flip like around. It took a while to get the pictures that they needed because she kept moving on them. But I thought it was absolutely adorable. I loved seeing her. I'm really sad that that's going to be my last ultrasound this pregnancy. I don't think they're going to give me another one unless they have some concerns, but so far she's looking great, so I don't think I'm gonna get another ultrasound. I do have some pictures here. I will show you guys that, and then I will show you guys my bump as well, because my bump has been growing a lot. It's getting so much bigger. So I will show that to you guys as well as her ultrasound pictures. So this is her ultrasound. She is just so stinking cute. I cannot wait to meet her and hold her. Okay, and here is my belly. This is from the side. I'm sure you guys can tell how much bigger it's getting. And this is the front. And then the other side. So she really is growing and my belly is definitely getting bigger. One thing I've noticed about this pregnancy that is different than my first pregnancy with my son is I am not gaining near as much weight. I am 22 weeks pregnant right now, as I said, and I believe I've gained around 10 to 11 pounds. So I am gaining so much less weight than I did with my son. I gained definitely more than like the recommended weight. In this pregnancy, I do have a toddler to run around and chase all the time. So I think that helps like keep my weight down as well. All my weight is just going straight to my belly. I'm not gaining it like all over. At least not yet. Maybe I'll get lucky. We'll just cross our fingers and hope. But that's all that I have to share for today's pregnancy update. I hope you guys enjoyed it. As I said before, I will have my previous pregnancy update linked down below in the description box. But thank you again so much for watching today's video. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.